passive infrared sensors, or PIR sensors for short, or just motion sensors are fully supported by Home Assistant and ESPHome. I have a question for you. Why to buy an expensive motion sensor when you can do it yourself for cheap? In this video, I will show you what parts you need, how to install ESPHome, how to add the motion sensor to Home Assistant, and how to make automations. Coming up! Hello, KPeyanski is here. Using smart motion sensors on strategic places at your home is one of the quick wins when you turn your home into a smart home. Of course, you can use out-of-the-box motion sensors like Shelly Motion or other similar, but they're not coming cheap, especially if you have to buy a lot of them. That is why we are going to create one that will cost around $4. And it will take only a few minutes of your time to make it. I will show you everything, step by step, and at the end, we will see a real demo with Home Assistant automation. And when we are talking about automations, I can show you one right now that is ridiculously easy. When you click on the gray like button, it automatically turns blue. Huh? What do you say? And it works every time. Try it out and see by yourself. Now let's start this video by showing what is needed for our cheap DIY motion sensor that works with Home Assistant and ESPHome. This is the D1 Mini, which is ESP8266 device, and it costs around $2 to $3 in AliExpress. It has a micro USB port and 4 megabytes of flash memory. I'll put links in the video description if you want to buy the same. It comes with these pins, but you have to solder them, and that is very easy. Look how easy it is exactly. If you are uncomfortable with soldering, you can always ask a friend to help you. D1 Mini can wirelessly connect to your internal network, and this is what exactly we are going to do. This is the PIR sensor that I'm using. It costs around $1. You can buy a pack of 5, which comes even cheaper. I will put a link in the video description if you want to buy the same sensor. And this is how you can see the sensor pinout. You will need 3 female-to-female jumper wires, also called DuPont wires. Of course, you can use any other wires you wish. USB A to micro USB cable is also needed, but I guess you have such somewhere. Some PIR sensors have the ground and the power supply pins swapped. Please open the plastic dome to see the pin mapping of your PIR sensor. Check that first, and then you need to connect the ground to a ground pin of your board and VCC to a 5V. Next, you need to connect the signal pin from the PIR sensor to GPIO 13 or D7 as it is written on the D1 Mini. Time to install ESPHome as a Home Assistant add-on, which is pretty easy, but not as easy as subscribing to my YouTube channel and hitting the notification bell. Nevertheless, let's see it. Click on Supervisor, Add-on Store, and search for ESPHome. Click on it and click on Install button. After the installation of ESPHome has finished, you can start the add-on and you can enable these switches for watchdog, auto-update and showing sidebar, or you can leave them disabled, it's up to you. Now I can open the ESPHome dashboard and I can add a node. The name will be PIR Sensor 1. And here I have to enter my Wi-Fi credentials. Then I can click Next. I have to select my ESP device. D1 Mini is ESP8266. Or I can pick a specific board. If your board is not a D1 Mini, please check ESPHome website to see what exactly to select here. For example, let's find where is Wemos D1 Mini. This is it. Then I can click Next and configuration is created. We are almost ready with the ESPHome. We just have to edit the ESPHome configuration a little bit.
I will click on the edit button. This is my ESPHome section, my sensor name, the platform, the board, logger is enabled. You can enable Home Assistant API, but I'll leave it like that. Over the air password, if you update the ESPHome later over the air, you can use this password. The Wi-Fi credentials, fallback hotspot, and captive portal. I'll have to add one more section. I'll open the ESPHome website and I'll search for PIR sensor. Here it is. And down below, I'll copy this binary sensor section and I'll paste it below captive portal. The only thing that I have to change is this pin. I'll type 13. This is for GPIO 13. As you remember, we connect the data cable to GPIO 13 or D7 on the D1 mini board. I'll save this and I'll close. Then I'll hit on validate to check the configuration. Everything is green and I can hit install. I have four options to choose from. This is the one that is interesting.
But this method now requires secure connection to your system via HTTPS protocol to work.
And you can plug the board into the computer that you're currently using. Unfortunately, I cannot use this because my connection is not HTTPS, it's not secure one. It's the regular HTTP. So I'll plug my PIR sensor, the D1 mini, to the computer where Home Assistant and respectively ESPHome is installed.
You can now connect the micro USB cable to the D1 mini. Please connect the D1 mini, our future motion sensor, to one of the USB ports of the device where Home Assistant and ESPHome are installed.
In my case, this is a Raspberry Pi 4. So I'll just plug the USB cable there, as it is easier for me than installing and running ESPHome via HTTPS. So I'll click this. It detects the USB port where the D1 mini is connected. I'll select it and I'll wait for the installation to finish. The installation has finished. The device is connected to my Wi-Fi. Everything seems fine and you can even see that the PIR sensor is sending its state. If I move in front of it, the state changes from on to off. That is a very good sign.
We are complete with the hardware part and the ESPHome part. The things that are left is to add the DIY motion sensor to Home Assistant and then to create some automations. Let's do this!
I can click on stop now and here you can see that I have a new notification. A new device has been discovered. Check it out. Where it is? No, not that one. PIR sensor 1. Here it is, my new device. I can click configure, submit, finish. I can now open this and I can add it to my Lovelace. Home, add to Lovelace UI. And currently, the sensor is clear. If I move my hand in front, the state is changed to detected. And it returns back very quickly, but this is a matter of settings with these two yellow knobs of the PIR sensor. You can adjust these settings as you wish.
Time to make a simple yet effective automation, which will be the following. When the motion sensor is activated, turn a light on. But before that, I have a challenge for you. If you reach this point and your PIR sensor is working at the moment, let me know in the comments by just type hashtag PIROwned. Now let's finish this Home Assistant automation.
I have added this smart Shelly bulb to test the PIR sensor and I'll go to configuration, automations, add automation, start with an empty automation. For example, will be the name of my automation. The trigger type will be state. The entity will be my PIR sensor. Here it is. When becomes on, with small letters. This is important. That means when it's activated. Call service. Light turn on. And the entity will be my Shelly Boop. That's it. I will save the automation. And now, if I go back to my Home Assistant dashboard, I have to disable it first. And if I move my hand in front of the sensor, the Shelly Boop is turned on. Great! Everything is working as expected.
For around $4 and several minutes of our life, we made a motion sensor that can be used in Home Assistant automations to make our home smarter. The only thing that is missing is to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that already, as well as 3D printed case for our motion sensor. I will leave a link to some 3D printed cases in the video description. I didn't try them, but you may like something from there. If you manage to make a 3D printed case by yourself, let me know in the comments and I promise to add a link to it in the video description and on my website. Feel free to secure this channel existence by becoming one of my Patreons, or you can use the other methods listed in the video description. Stay safe and don't forget, home smart but not hard. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next Wednesday.